I need help with Heil air conditioner troubleshooting.
Heil air conditioners are under investigation for too thin evaporator coils that start leaking.
AC coils leak all the time, especially since Freon was banned and more corrosive high-pressure refrigerant alternatives came out.
Okay, thinner than they should be, so they corrode and leak way sooner than they otherwise would. And that's despite cleaning off the grime so it does not rust.
I thought it was the oils that they used that made some of the coils to corrode.
The cause really does not matter if you have to pay a couple thousand to replace the coils and add refrigerant.
Fortunately, I do not have an obvious set of leaky coils. Unfortunately, I cannot figure out what is wrong.
Heil says not to run their ACs when it is below 55 degrees.
If it is below 55 degrees, you should be running the heater. That, or the AC works too well, and that's not my problem.
Heil's manuals say to keep at least a foot on all sides of the unit for proper venting of waste heat so you do not overheat.
I put that in the same category of checking for blockage of the vents or clogged filters for why it is not able to push cold air to the rest of the house. Also known as, it fails if you do not maintain it, and I pay someone to do that.
So then you know you did not damage the coil fins by scrubbing it too hard, instead of using a soft brush on a vacuum cleaner.
Honestly, I never thought to vacuum the AC. Then again, I hardly ever vacuum inside the house.
There's also the question of whether or not there is a refrigerant leak. If it is losing refrigerant, the unit could ice up.
And when it is 90, not 50.
If you hear sizzling, that means it is frosting over and defrosting, assuming there is not smoke coming up from the unit.
The only benefit of the AC being on fire is that I would be rather certain what was wrong with it.
I'm assuming the thermostat is set to cool and the fan is on, to circulate the air and the temperature on the thermostat is set to less than it is in the house.
I put that in the category of common sense.
It is a common enough problem they put it in the maintenance manual, so I thought I'd ask. The other question is whether you have a broken temperature sensor in the AC that thinks it is already cool, or broken thermostat that does not realize you're hot.
I can at least turn down the thermostat lower and see if that works.
And if you have to turn it to 50 to make the house 70, you know that you need a service call.